Are you serious? What? I said, what? Just everybody settle down if you can't calm down. Get a cup of coffee and calm down. Okay, you're not worried about the NSA, you say? You're not worried about Big Brother watching, Big Brother hacking in on your emails, your text messages, your instant messages? You better be, because I'm going to tell you something. I just watched a video that was recorded in South Bend, Indiana. I was just on the phone with Mike Childers, who produces our broadcast for us from our church services and makes our graphics and does all this work. He just got done sending me an email to these two guys that are hackers who actually are able to take over a car. They're sitting in the back seat of this car, and they're using a computer. They can make the speedometer start reading. It's doing 199 miles an hour when you're not. This guy's driving it. They can turn his steering wheel either way they want to. They can remove his brakes where he can't stop. They can speed up his car. They can slow it down. They can engage the airbags. They can cause the horn to blow. They can do anything they want to do. They can rev up. They can do anything they want to do with it, sitting in the back seat with a laptop. So, understand something. These guys know how to do it. They already know how to do it. And they can do it. They figured out this one car. They can figure out any car. They can figure out anything. Planes, trains, all of the lights in a city. Imagine hackers changing all the lights in a major city, causing all the lights to go green, people racing up on intersections in rush hour, massive pileups. Everybody would not know what happened because the light was green. Or speeding up a train to take a curve too fast to crash. Or hacking airplanes and telling the pilot that his altitude is, you're still at 10,000 feet when he's only at 1,000 feet. Or telling him he's traveling at one speed when he's really traveling at another speed, causing him to crash on landing. I mean, folks, you've got to understand, this is a whole new level, and I just watched the video. I'm going to put the link below. I'd love to show it to you, but that'd be a violation of copyright violation. So I'm going to put the link below. You click on that link. It'll take you straight there. I want you to watch it. It's a four-minute video of these two guys hacking a car as this guy's trying to drive it in South Bend, Indiana. It will blow your mind. They tore the dash off the car, figured out where all the computers were, and wrote the software into a laptop. Now that they've got that model figured out, they can do it to any vehicle of that model. And that's just one. All they got to do is, once they get this system figured out, they can start doing that to different models. They can start doing it to planes, trains. You name it, they can do it. Think. That's why the Bible says it was in the days of Noah, so shall be in the coming Son of Man. Because every imagination of their heart was on evil continually. And this ability is beyond your comprehension. We're out of control. And what if the corruption was in the government and the TSA wanted you to crash? They just wait till you're driving down the interstate 70 miles an hour, 75 miles an hour, and just whip it right into a grove of trees and take your brakes out while they're at it. Boom! So-and-so died today in a terrible automobile accident on I-75 near Calhoun, Georgia. What are you going to do? You think you're in control? You're not in control. God's in control. Man is corrupting himself to the point. That's why the microchip is coming, folks. And if you can tell a computer to do something and make a car do something and override you manually, then what happens if they can implant a small microchip antenna into the base of your brain? Can they tell your emotions what to do, overriding you manually? Is that what it means by once they take the mark of the beast? Could it? I'm just saying. Could it be that once you take the mark of the beast, the reason you're damned is you can't get back because they override your conscience? You'll be sealed. Your conscience becomes sealed like with a hot iron. They'll cause you to sell your soul and you don't even know you're selling it. And it's in the Bible. It talks about in the souls of men. And everything gets sold, including the souls of men. Are you saved? Are you saved? Well, Paul, I've got plenty of time, right? Do you? Do you know when Jesus is coming? Are you going to be left behind? Or what are you going to do? Are you going to deal with this stuff even before Jesus comes? Because we don't know how far into the beginning of sorrows we got to go. Do you know? No, you don't. Neither do I. So as we see this corruption surrounding us, not only in the governments of the world and the currencies of the world and the technology of the world, but in the spiritual aspect, there's spiritual wickedness even in high places. And men's lives are at stake. But men's souls are hanging on the balance. I'm Pastor Paul Begley. I'm gonna get off this and let you go watch this video. And then imagine just how close you are to the end of time. The coming apocalypse is truly upon us. Now, I'm going to show this video that I'm talking about today live on my live show several times, and we're going to talk about it. I'm going to show it a couple times. We're going to talk about it live. You can be in the chat room. After we show it live, you can watch it live and then chat live with the rest of the people there. The mark of the beast is coming. The technology's upon us. So don't miss today's show. It starts at 12 noon Eastern. From 12 to 3 p.m. at www, go to my website, www.paulbegleyprophecy.com. That's www.paulbegleyprophecy.com. You want to know why there's FEMA camps? You want to know why there's FEMA coffins? You want to know why there's guillotines?